Good afternoon, children. Now we have last class discussed about Newton's first law of motion, which is defined the inertia. Now today discuss about the Newton's second law of motion, which is defined momentum. The rate of change of momentum of the body is directly proportional to the applied force, unbalanced force. The change in momentum, it is the direction of the force. They have two types of force, balance and unbalance. Unbalanced force act on a body, change its position. So the force is directly proportional to the rate of change of momentum. Yani force is proportional to final momentum minus initial momentum. Yani force is proportional to mb minus mu by t, where F is proportional to mv minus u by t, where v minus u by t is known as acceleration. Rate of change of velocity with respect to time is known as acceleration. Rate of change of velocity is known as acceleration. So force is proportional to mass into acceleration. Therefore, force is equal to a constant k m into a, where k is known as force constant and F is equal to m into a. So Newton's second law of motion, the applied force of an object can be given by the product of mass of an object and acceleration product in it. When the force act on it, then change in acceleration, change in velocity with respect to time, and such are known as Newton's second law. Its SI unit of force is known as Newton, and 1 Newton is equal to 1 kg into 1 meter per second square. Now we have defined 1 Newton is that force which, when the acting on a mass 1 kg produced in its acceleration 1 meter per second square in the direction of force act on it. So the 1 Newton force defined as when the force 1 kg of mass accelerate in 1 meter per second square in a direction of force act on it. Application of Newton's second law of motion. Taking a catch, wearing a seat belt in a car, falling off a high jumper on a soft bed. Some examples of the Newton's second law. Taking a catch, ball, the moves in arms in backwards and the direction of the ball while taking the catch. The fielders doing too. So increase the time and decrease rate of change of momentum according to Newton's second law. So force is equal to rate of change of momentum. Second, just like the falling the high jumpers in soft bed, in the high jumpers active their athletics are made to fall on a soft crust floor or sandy floor. This decreases the rate of change of momentum by increasing the time taken. As the rate of change of momentum is small, so the force due to the fall is smaller, thereby the athletics is not hard. So some examples which have the Newton's second law of motions. Impulse force, the force which has high magnitude and its act for a very short duration of time is called impulse force. The force act on a body very short time intervals, change in magnitudes, change in force act on a body very short time intervals is called impulse. So the impulse force is equal to force into time, and impulse is denoted by I, force into time. The SI unit of force is known as Newton and time is second. So the SI unit of impulse is Newton second. We know that the SI force have kg per meter per second square into second. So second and second becomes to be cancelled and to find Newton second. So SI unit of impulse
हैव न्यूटन सेकेंड इम्पल्स द फोर्स एक्ट ऑन ए बॉडी वेरी शॉर्ट टाइम इंटरवल्स चेंज इन मोमेंटम सो इट इज नोन एज इम्पल्स इम्पल्स हैविंग हाई मैग्नीट्यूड बट वेरी शॉर्ट टाइम इंटरवल्स जैसा यूनिट ऑफ इम्पल्स इज नोन एज न्यूटन सेकेंड सो द मोमेंटम बिकम्स टू बी चेंज वेरी शॉर्ट टाइम इंटरवल्स इज नोन एज इम्पल्स
न्यूटन्स थर्ड लॉ ऑफ मोशन फर्स्ट लॉ डिफाइन द इनर्सिया सेकेंड लॉ डिफाइन द मोमेंटम एंड थर्ड लॉ डिफाइन द कंजर्वेशन ऑफ मोमेंटम सो द न्यूटन्स थर्ड लॉ ऑफ मोशन टू एवरी एक्शन देयर इज एन इक्वल एंड अपोजिट रिएक्शन वेयर एज द एक्शन एंड रिएक्शन एक्ट्स इन डिफरेंट ऑब्जेक्ट इन अपोजिट सो न्यूटन्स थर्ड लॉ एक्शन एंड रिएक्शन इक्वल एंड अपोजिट in each and every objects. For example, the firing of a shot from a gun, walking, rowing of a boat, flying of a rocket, swimming, flying bird are the examples of Newton's third law of motion. First, the firing of a shot from gun. When the gun is fired, the bullet shoots out due to the force applied by it and triggers off their gun. Reaction as per Newton's third law of motion, the bullet exerted equal and opposite force on the gun. This gives the backward jerk to their shoulders and supporting to the gun. This gun recoils. So we action and reaction equal and opposite walking when you walk on the ground then our foot push the ground backwards the action and reaction as per Newton's third law ground push our foot forward with equal force under the walks push the ground faster than he walk.
Newton's third law of motion, action and reaction equal and opposite. This law is defined the conservation of momentum. According to law of conservation of momentum, linear momentum, the total momentum of the system remains same in absence of external force applied. Before the collision and after the collision, momentum have remained same, such are known as conservation of momentum. Now we have to take two objects A and B, having mass m1 and m2 and initial velocity u1 and u2 respectively. Now the force applied on object A and B after the collision, the both bodies final velocity becomes to v1 and v2. So the object collides after the A object having final velocity v1 and B object having final velocity v2. After t times, the object collides to each other. According to Newton's third law of motion, f1 is equal to f2, action and reaction equal and opposite, but F2 is a minus because have opposite in direction. So F1 is equal to minus F2. Action and reaction equal and opposite. According to third law of Newton's, F1 is equal to minus F2. F1 is equal to M1 into A1 and F2 is equal to M2 into A2, where M1 is known as mass of object A and A1 is acceleration of an object A. M2 is mass of an object B and acceleration of mass and object B, A2. So M1 is equal to B1 minus U1 by T and is equal to minus M2 V2 minus U2 by T. Now T cancel both sides. So now multiply M1 B1 minus M1 U1 is equal to minus M2 V2 plus M2 U2 and M1 V1 plus M2 V2 is equal to m1 u1 plus m2 u2. And that means the before the collision, the object A and B have the momentum m1 u1 plus m2 u2. And after the collision, the momentum of object m1 b1 plus m2 b2. Total momentum have remained same. That means before the collision and after the collision, momentum have remained same. Such are known as conservation of momentum. Momentum is never change. Total momentum have remained same before collision, after collision. Such are known as conservation of momentum. So Newton's third law defines the conservation of momentum. Finally, the first law have defined the inertia, and second law defined the momentum, and third law defined the conservation of momentum.